Hello, welcome to Bite Size Med. This video is on the cardiac cycle, and in part two, we'll look at the ventricular volume changes that take place during one cardiac cycle. The cardiac cycle includes events that happen in the heart from one beat to the next. What does it do? It contracts to pump blood out, and it relaxes while it fills. The contraction is systole, and relaxation is diastole. And it happens both in the atria and the ventricles during the course of each cycle. We can start anywhere in the cycle, but if we start with atrial systole, that's followed by atrial diastole. Atrial diastole is longer, and since the cycle will repeat, it's followed by atrial systole. This is the atrial systole of the next cycle. Ventricular systole happens after atrial systole, and it's longer. The rest of the duration is ventricular diastole, so the phases will overlap between the chambers. Atrial systole overlaps with late ventricular diastole. So we have atrial systole followed by ventricular systole, ventricular diastole, and atrial systole again. To understand what happens, I'm going to be using this schematic heart with the right atrium, the left atrium, the right ventricle, and the left ventricle. The superior and inferior vena cava open into the right atrium, and the pulmonary veins into the left atrium. The pulmonary trunk emerges from the right ventricle, and the aorta from the left ventricle. Between the atria and the ventricles are the atrioventricular valves. That's the tricuspid valve on the right and the mitral valve on the left. Between the ventricles and these two big vessels are the semilunar valves. That's the pulmonary valve and the aortic valve. Now let's see how the volume changes in the ventricles during the cardiac cycle. Let's start with atrial systole. What happens? The atria contract and the last bit of filling in the ventricles is complete. What would happen to the volume? Since the ventricles are filling, the volume increases. A little bit, because remember this is just the last bit of blood that the atria are pushing into the ventricles. At the end of atrial systole, the atrioventricular valves close. Now both the atrioventricular and the semilunar valves are closed and the ventricles contract. This is the end of ventricular diastole and the start of ventricular systole. All the valves are closed. Blood neither enters nor leaves the ventricle. This is isovolumetric contraction. Isovolumetric, the volume doesn't change. At the end of this phase, the semilunar valves open. And the ventricles eject blood out. There's rapid ejection and then slow ejection. But the point is that it's ejecting blood out. Blood is leaving the ventricle, so the volume decreases. Now we're at the end of ventricular systole. The valves close. The ventricles relax with all the valves closed. This is isovolumetric relaxation. Again, just like isovolumetric contraction, the volume doesn't change because all the valves are closed. Once the atrioventricular valves open, the ventricles start filling, first rapidly and then slow filling. It's filling, so obviously the volume is going to rise. Most of the filling happens during this stage. But the last bit of filling, remember, is from atrial contraction, which happens during atrial systole. So now we're back where we started, and the whole thing is going to repeat again. If we look at a graph for the volume changes over the course of one cardiac cycle, it would look something like this. So this curve would be the same on both sides of the heart because almost the same volume of blood circulates through the right ventricle as the left. Just that from the right ventricle, blood goes to the lungs, and from the left ventricle, it goes to the rest of the body. Let's assume that this curve is for the left ventricle. We can then change the valve names, so the atrioventricular valve becomes the mitral valve, and the semilunar valve becomes the aortic valve. During atrial systole, the atria contract, and the volume in the ventricles rises a little. This is the end of ventricular diastole. The mitral valve closes. During ventricular systole, there is isovolumetric contraction, where the volume stays the same. When the aortic valve opens, during the ejection phase, the volume reduces, as the ventricle is pumping out the blood until we reach its lowest value at the end of ventricular systole. The aortic valve closes. The volume doesn't change during isovolumetric relaxation. The mitral valve opens, and as the ventricles fill, the volume increases. The last bit of filling is from atrial systole. And repeat. So that's what the curve would sort of look like. Now let's take it further. From here to here would be one cardiac cycle. There's ventricular systole with the isovolumetric contraction and the ejection phases, followed by ventricular diastole for the rest of the cycle. The volume in the ventricle at the end of diastole, that is called the end diastolic volume. Let's assume that's around 120 ml. Now these numbers are usually ranges, but we're assuming 120 just to understand it for now. During systole, blood was ejected out, and not all of it gets pumped out. At the end of systole, the volume of blood that remains in the ventricles is the end systolic volume. Let's assume that's around 50 ml. The difference between these two volumes would be the volume of blood ejected by the ventricle in each cycle, and each cycle is a beat for the heart. A beat is a stroke, and this is called the stroke volume. So the stroke volume is the difference between the end diastolic volume and the end systolic volume. Here, 120 minus 50 would give us 70 ml. The fraction of that end diastolic volume that the heart ejected is the ejection fraction. What did it pump out? The stroke volume. So the ejection fraction is the stroke volume over the end diastolic volume. In other words, it's the difference between the end diastolic volume and the end systolic volume over the end diastolic volume. With these numbers, that would be 70 over 120, which is 0.58 or 58%. The left ventricular ejection fraction is used to assess left ventricular function. This is one cardiac cycle, and the stroke volume would be pumped out during each ventricular systolic contraction. And if we assume the heart beats at a rate of 72 beats per minute, each minute the blood pumped out would be the stroke volume multiplied by the heart rate. That's 70 times 72, which is 5040, approximately 5000 ml, or 5 liters a minute. This is the volume of blood pumped out by the heart per minute. It's called the cardiac output. So the cardiac output is the stroke volume multiplied by the heart rate. It is per minute versus the stroke volume, which is per beat. So that's the end diastolic volume, the end systolic volume, the stroke volume, the ejection fraction, and the cardiac output. And those are all the volume changes that happen during the cardiac cycle. In part 3, we'll look at some of the pressure changes. I hope this video was helpful. If it was, you can give it a like and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.